Yes. So this is my 16th video on ordinary differential equation in the playlist of UPSC Max Optional. So if you haven't watched the videos from part 1 to part 14, in the description there is a ODE playlist link. So please go through that link and then you watch all the videos and come back to this video, right? Because if you watch this video straight away, I'm sure that it will be difficult for you to understand. So please watch from part 1 to part 14 and then come back to part 15. And in the description, I have provided the link for Telegram channel. So I have given the name for Telegram channel. So if you are new, you can also join the Telegram channel. You'll get regular updates in that channel, right? Yeah. So we are in the first. So what we did in the ODE is from part 1 to part 10, what we did is we have solved some problems based on formation of differential equations, right? So we have solved almost more than 27-28 problems based on formation of differential equation. And from part 11, we are moved on to second topic. So second topic is the solution of second and higher order differential equation with constant coefficients, right? So we are in this topic now. So in this topic there are 6 types. So I have given in the 11th video, I have given all 6 types. So type 0 is RHS is of the form 0, right? So there will be no term in the RHS. And type 1 will be RHS is of the form e power ax, and type 2 will be RHS is of the form sin ax or cos ax. So in the last two videos we have been solving problems based on type 2 problem, and in type 2 what we did is I have splitted this into 3 cases. So first I splitted the type 2 into 2 cases. The first is second order and the second is higher order. In second order I have split this into 2 cases. When the equation does not have a d term, so we will call it as a case 1. When the equation has D term, we will call it as case 2, and case 3 will be some higher order. So in this case, we have solved almost around 9 problems, I think. So you can go through that. So these are the problems that I solved in the previous videos. So again, I repeat, if you haven't watched all the previous videos, so you please watch the previous videos and then come back to this video if you are new to this channel. So you can see that I have solved almost, let me go fast. Yeah, so I have solved 7 problems and I have given some problems for you to do exercise also. So and then we are moved on to case 2 in the last video, right? So in the last video we moved on to case 2. That is, case 2 is second order and the equation has D term in it. So we have followed some method to find the solution for this case. In the last video I have explained these problems, right? So I think I have solved around 4 to 5 problems and then I have given some exercise problems for you. Now what we are going to do is, now we are going to solve some higher order equations, right? So we have already solved one problem on higher order equation. So in the last two videos we have solved only second order. Second order means we have only d square y by dx square term. We won't have d cube or d power 4 etc. Now we are going to solve higher order equations. So we have already solved one problem in the previous video. D cube plus 9d of y is equal to sin 3x. So I'm going to solve another two problems based on higher order, and then I'm going to give some exercise problems for you, and then I'm going to discuss type 3. So type 3 is very, very important. Type 3 is just a combination of type 1 and type 2. So first let me do two problems on higher order in this case, and then I'll give some exercise problems, then we'll move on to type 3. So I'm going to finish type 3 also in this video, because type 3 is just an extension of type 1 and type 2. So we will solve problems now. Yes, yeah. So this is second problem in higher order equation, and again I repeat, if you haven't watched the previous videos then only you understand this video, because the complementary function I have explained in the 11th part. So if you straight away watch this video, I will write the formula straight away, so it will be difficult for you to follow. So kindly watch from part 1 to part 15. This is part 16, right? Yeah. So solve d square y by dx power 4 minus m power 4 into y is equal to sin mx. Now you can see, first you have to fix the topic. So you can see this is a second order equation. Sorry, it is d power 4, right? D power 4. So you can see it is a fourth order equation. So it comes under higher order equation. And you can see this m is a constant. So this m belongs to R. So you can see the coefficients are the numbers. So therefore it is second and higher order equation with constant coefficient. So first we fix the topic. And inside the topic, we can see the RHS of the form sin mx. So we are in type 2, right? Yeah. So first, in order to find the general solution, the general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So first, we will find the complementary function. So this equation is same as d power 4 minus m power 4 of y is equal to sin mx, right? So if you have watched the previous videos, then it will be very easy for you to follow this. So I'm just replacing d to be dy by dx. So for finding the complementary function, first we need to find the auxiliary equation. So for auxiliary equation, we just have to replace d by, already it is m here. So what we will do is we will replace some other number. Okay, let it be. Okay, d power 4 minus m power 4 is equal to 0. So that means d power 4 is equal to m power 4. So d power 4 is equal to m power 4. Or else I can also solve like this. Okay, let me solve in another way so it will be easy for you. So I can write this as d square whole square minus m square whole square is equal to 0. Now I can use the formula a square minus b square. So in place of a, I have d square. In place of b, I have m square. So this is nothing but d square plus m square into d square minus m square is equal to 0. So when I solve this, we will have d square minus m square is equal to 0. So this means d square is equal to m square. So this means d is equal to plus or minus m. So when I solve this equation, we will have d square plus m square is equal to 0. So d square is equal to minus m square. Remember, this is fourth order equation. So you will have four roots, right? That means d square is equal to I square m square. So I'm just replacing I square to be minus 1. That means d is equal to plus or minus I. So therefore, the roots are plus m minus m and plus or minus m I. So you have to write the complementary function. So you can see from these two, the roots are real and distinct, and here the roots are imaginary. So you know how to write the complementary function if you have watched the previous videos. So the roots are real, and if you know that if the roots are real and distinct, the complementary function will be c1 e power mx plus c2 e power m1x m2x. So m1 m2 are the distinct roots. So and we know that if the roots are imaginary, that is, it is of the form alpha plus or minus I beta, the complementary function will be e power alpha x into a cos beta x plus b sin beta x. Or you can also replace some constant. Let me write some constant, right? So a cos beta x. So if I do that, you can see of four roots, the first two roots are real and distinct. So for first two roots, what I'll write is e power. So you can see the first root is m. So I write mx plus c2 e power minus mx. Suppose if you have 1 and 2, you have to replace here by 1x and 2x plus. And from here, you can see this is of the form, this is imaginary root. And if you compare this with this term, here alpha is equal to 0. It is of the form 0 plus or minus mi. So alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to 1. So e power 0x into, let me write c3 cos, our beta is m, c3 cos mx plus c4 sin mx. Therefore, the complementary function is c1 e power mx plus c2 e power minus mx plus c3 cos mx plus c4 sin mx, because e power 0x is 1. This is the complementary function. So next we need to find the particular integral. So you know how to find the particular integral for type 2. So again I repeat, you please watch the previous videos. So it is given that it is d power 4 minus m power 4 into sin mx. Now if it is second order, what we will do, we will replace d square is equal to minus of m square, right? D square is equal to minus of m square. But again, you can see the higher order. So what we need to do is, in the previous video I have said, if you have higher order, we have to reduce this to a second order. So I can write this as, so again I am going to write this as d square plus m square, d square minus m square into sin mx. Right? Now I can replace d square is equal to minus of m square. minus of a, we have to replace d square is equal to minus of a square. Here a is m, right? If r is of the form sin ax, we have to replace d square is equal to minus of a square. So we compare, we have a is equal to m. So now it's a very important step. If I replace d square is equal to minus m square, minus m, I have to replace this by minus m square. You can see this is non-zero, but this will be a zero. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to substitute only here. So if I substitute, this will be zero, this will be non-zero, right? So I'm going to substitute d square is equal to minus m square only here. So we will have minus m square minus m square, and I'm going to keep this as it is, d square plus m square into sin mx, right? So this will be minus 1 by 2m square. Now I'm going to substitute d square is equal to minus m square here. So if I substitute d square is equal to minus m square, so again replace d square is equal to minus m square. Remember, if you haven't watched the previous videos, it will be difficult for you to follow. So if you are new, please watch the previous videos, right? So you will be thinking that I'm going fast or I'm not explaining some steps. The only thing is, if you haven't watched the previous videos, it will be difficult for you to understand. So if we replace d square is equal to minus m square here, so we will have minus m square plus m square into sin mx. Now you can see this denominator is 0. So if this denominator is 0, what we will do? We have to multiply x, and then we have to differentiate the denominator with respect to d. So we will have, so this becomes, so we have to multiply x here, so we have multiplied x. I have to differentiate this with respect to d. So we will have 2d, and then you have to put this term as it is. Now I can write this as minus 2m square. I can take x by 2 outside. So I can take x by 2 outside, and this is nothing but 1 by d of sin mx. So you know, when we have 1 by d, we have to integrate, and if we have d of something, you have to differentiate. So when I combine this two, we have minus x by 4m square. Now we have to integrate this. So we have to integrate sin mx dx. So this will be minus x by 4m square, and integration of sin mx will be minus cos mx divided by m. So if I multiply, so this will get positive. So x by 4m cube into cos mx is the particular integral, right? So the general solution will be, we have to add complementary function on the particular integral. So the general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So you just write the complementary function, which we got is c1 e power mx plus c2 e power minus mx plus c3 cos mx plus c4 sin mx. This is the complementary function, and particular integral is x by 4m cube into cos mx. This is the general solution. Now you can see these are the solutions. Now we'll move on to some more problems. So last problem I'm going to solve in higher order. So from this you will finish type 2, right? So I think we have solved more than 20 problems, I think, on type 2. So we have mastered type 0, type 1, type 2 now, right? Yeah. So we'll move on to third problem. So remember, it is more than 20 problem I think I have solved. So this is third problem on this case, that is higher order. So let me solve one more problem and then we'll wind up. So solve d minus 1 whole square d square plus 1 whole square of y equal to sin mx. And I want to say one thing, that this question that we solved before is asked in IAS 1991. This is a previous year's question. It's a previous year's question, PYQ. Okay. So first we will find the auxiliary. First we will find the general. We have to find the general solution. So general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So first we will find the complementary function. So complementary function will be, first we have to find the auxiliary equation. You have to replace d by m, or you can also solve this as usual. So it will be m square plus 1 whole square is equal to 0. Now you can see this is a sixth order equation, right? Because here we have a d square term, here we have d power 4 term, we multiply we have d power 6 term. So we have to find the 6 roots. So according to the nature of 6 roots, we have to write the complementary function. So when I solve this, you can see 1 is equal root, right? 1 comma 1 is the root. So very easy. You can also solve this by m square minus 2. You can also solve this by expanding a minus b whole square formula. But it is in factorized form. So you can see m minus 1 is equal to 0 means m is equal to 1. And since we have 2, it means equal roots. Now we have to solve this. So m square plus 1 is equal to 0 means m square is equal to minus 1. M is equal to plus or minus I twice. Because the roots we have square term here. So that means now we can write the complementary function. So you know how to write the complementary function. So here we have 1 comma 1. Here the roots are real and equal. Here the roots are imaginary and equal. So let me write down. So the roots, only there are 4 cases. The two formulas that I have written here, the roots are real and distinct, the roots are imaginary. And another 2 formulas I did here. I already explained in the previous videos. Okay. If the roots are real and equal, the complementary function will be c1 plus c2x into e power mx. M is the root that we got. So here m is equal to 1. If the roots are imaginary and equal, the roots are imaginary and equal, that is alpha plus r minus I beta twice. So the complementary function will be, as you know, this e power alpha x into c1 plus c2x cos beta x plus c3 plus c4x sin beta x. Now you have to apply the formula here. So complementary function will be, now you can see these two roots are real and equal. So I write this as c1 plus c2x into e power 1 into x, because our m is equal to 1. And here the roots are equal and imaginary. So when you compare this with alpha plus r minus I beta, we have 0 plus r minus I. That means alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to 1. So when I substitute alpha is equal to 0 here, we have e power 0 x into, let me write some more constant because I have written c1, c2. So let me write c3 plus c4x into sin, our beta is 1 into x, plus c5 plus c6x into cos x. Sin x or cos x, right? You can change this. That doesn't problem. So the complementary function is c1 plus c2x into e power x plus c3 plus c4x into cos x. Okay, let me write first cos and then sin. Cos x plus c5 plus c6x into sin x. Sorry, we have only c4x. So we don't c3 plus c4x. C5 plus C6x. So we have only x here. This will remain constant. Okay, let me write clear. So C3 plus C4x into cos x plus C5 plus C6x into sin x. This is the complementary function. Now we need to find the particular integral, right? So this is somewhat tricky. Since this is higher order, we have to reduce this to second order. So how are we going to reduce this? The case here. So it is d minus 1 whole square, d square plus 1 whole square is equal to sin mx. This is what the particular integral is. So if the equation is of the second order, we can substitute straight away that d square is equal to minus m square. But here, what's the problem is, it is the 6th order equation. So what we need to do is, we need to reduce this to some second order. We need to reduce this to a second order equation. Now what I'm going to do is, okay, let me continue this. So it is not sin mx, the question is sin x, right? So please change the question. It is sin x. Sin x, right? That is our a is equal to 1 here, right? Yeah. So we will do this. So we have to replace d square is equal to minus of a square. So when you compare this with sin ax, we have a is equal to 1. That means you have to replace d square is equal to minus 1. But what the problem is, when you replace d square is equal to minus 1, you can see this term will be 0 And here we don't have d square term. So that means you have to reduce this equation, then only it will be easy for us to solve. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply and divide by some term. So let me watch this carefully. So first I'm going to keep this term as it is, d square plus 1 whole square. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply and divide by d plus 1 whole square, d plus 1 whole square. This d minus 1 whole square I'm writing as it is into sin x, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm just multiplying and dividing by this term. The whole remaining term is as it is. So I can write this as 1 by d square plus 1 whole square, and the numerator will be d plus 1 whole square, and denominator will be, you can see, I can write this as d plus 1 into d minus 1 whole square into sin x. Now this I can write this to be 1 by d square plus 1 whole square. I can expand this, so we will have d square plus 2d plus 1 divided by, you can see this a plus b, a minus b. It will be a square minus b square, and already we have square here into sin x. Into sin x. Now what I can do is, now I can combine this term and this term, right? A plus b, a minus b. So in place of a, I have d square, and in place of b, I have this. So I'll keep the numerator as it is. So I can write this to be our a d power 4 minus 1 whole square, right? So I can combine the equation to be d square plus 1 into d square minus 1 whole square, and this is a plus b into a minus b. So it will be a square minus b square, and our a is d square. So it will be d square whole square will be d power 4 minus 1 whole square into sin x. Into sin x. Right? Yeah. Okay, let me do in some other way. So if you do this in way, the problem maybe get longer. So what I'll do is, at this stage itself, I'll replace d square is equal to minus a square in this term, right? So I'll replace d square is equal to minus 1. So this will be a non-zero denominator, right? Yeah. So whenever you have d square, here we can't replace because it will be 0. So d square plus 1 whole square. So this is d square plus 2d plus 1. This will be minus 1 minus 1 whole square into sin x. So just replace d square to be equal to minus 1 here. So this will be minus 2. So minus 2 square will be 1 by 4. So I can take 1 by 4 outside. So we will have 1 by d square plus 1 whole square into d square plus 2d plus 1 of sin x. Right? Now whenever you have d of something, you have to differentiate, right? So if you have watched the previous videos, you will be very clear. So what I'll do is, so I'll write 1 by 4, 1 by d square plus 1 whole square. Now I need to, I'm going to multiply sin x to all the term. So we will have d square of sin x plus 2 into d of sin x plus sin x. Right? Yeah. So this will now be changed to 1 by 4. So 1 by d square plus 1 whole square. And we have to differentiate sin x twice. D square means you have to differentiate twice. So first, if we differentiate sin x, we will have cos x. And if we differentiate cos x, we will have minus sin x. So this term will be minus sin x. Plus, we have to differentiate sin x once. So we will have 2 cos x. 2 is already there. It is d of sin x. So we have to differentiate sin x. Plus sin x already there. This is only 1 sin x. There is no d term behind this, so we don't need to differentiate. So I can cancel these two terms. So we have left with 1 by 4, 1 by d square plus 1 whole square into 2 cos x. Now you can see we have reduced the system to a second order equation, right? So whenever you have some higher order equation, you have to reduce this to a second order equation. Now we can do this very easily, right? So I can cancel this 2. So this will be 2 ones are to 2s are. Now we have to follow that same technique which we did for solving the second order equation type 1, right? Yeah. Yes. Now I think you can follow this very easily. This is a type 2 case, type 2 case 1. So you have to replace d square is equal to minus 1. So it will be minus 1 plus 1 will be 0. So you have to multiply x, and then you have to differentiate the denominator. So and then if you differentiate the denominator, this 1 will be cancelled. So we have only d square term, right? So sorry, 2d term. So you take 2 outside and differentiate and integrate cos x, you will have this as an answer x by 4 sin x, right? This is the particular integral. Now we can also, the general solution is y is equal to cf plus pi. So just verify, this is a type 2 case 1. So you can easily solve this. The answer is x by 4 sin x. You will verify, right? I think it will be x by 4 sin x. You can also verify that. Okay, let me complete. Yes. So now we'll move on to type 3, right? So type 3 will be RHS is of the form x power n, right? Yeah. So that means RHS will be a equation of x. For x. So we'll move on to type 3. RHS is of the form x power n. That means the RHS can be an equation of x. For example, x square plus 2x plus 1, x cube plus 3, it's a polynomial equation in x, right? So, it can be a polynomial equation in x. So, we are going to solve these types of problem. So, remember, I'll just repeat what we did. So, in type 0, we have RHS is of the form 0. In type 1, there will be no RHS. So, the general solution will be, we have to find only the complementary function. So, in type 1, we have RHS to be e power ax. In type 2, what we have is RHS is sin ax or cos ax. So, we have finished this type and this type. And type 3 is RHS is of the form x power n. That is, it can be a polynomial equation in x. So, if we do this type, then type 4, type 5, type 6 are just the extension of first 3 types, right? So, we understand the first 4 types, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. Then you can do these 4, 5, 6 in your own. So, now we are in this stage, that is type 3. So, RHS is of the form x power n. So, the only thing that is different here is the particular integral will be different for all. So, here the particular, there will be no particular integral. So, here in order to find the particular integral, we should replace d is equal to a. And here we need to find the particular integral, we need to replace d square is equal to minus of a square, right? So, if you haven't watched all the previous videos, if you have to watch the previous videos, then only you will be understand what I am saying. Now, here in the RHS, we are going to have x power n. So, we are going to solve these types of problem. I am going to teach you how to solve these types of problem. So, if you understand, if you know these two formulas, then you can solve any problems in type 3. So, 1 plus x over power minus 1 is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on. So, 1 minus x will be 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on. Right? So, first I will solve one problem and then I will explain with this. Right? So, first sum is solve d square plus 2d plus 2 of y equal to x square. Now, first you have to identify the topic, right? So, let me show you one document which I showed in the previous videos. Yes, here it is. It's opening. Yeah. Adjust with it. My computer is damn slow. Yeah. So, we are in a ordinary differential equation. So, we have solved from part 1 to part 10. We have solved this topic. So, I have said I can solve. I will come back to second topic later. Now, we are in third topic. So, second and higher order linear equations with constant coefficients. Type 1 to type 6. That is what we are solving from part 11 to part 16. So, here we have 6 types. That is what we are in type 3 now. Right. So, type 3 will be RHS of the form x power n. So, it is a second and higher order equations with constant coefficients, right? So, first you have to identify the topic. So, you can see this is a second order equation and you can see the coefficients are constants here. So, you can see the coefficients are constants. This is one here. So, that means we are in the third topic. So, first you fix the topic first and then you fix the type. So, what is the type here? It is in type 3. So, whenever you see the question, first you have to identify the topic and inside the topic you have to identify the type. So, if you have some variable here, for example, the question will be xd square plus xd plus 2 of y is equal to some number, some function. Here you can see the coefficient is a variable. Now, we are in fourth topic. second order linear equation with variable coefficients, right? So we have not solved this topic. Now we are only in this topic. So let me solve this later, right? Yeah. So first you identify the topic and then go back to the problem. So there is a second order equation with constant coefficient. So we are in third topic. In third topic we are in type 3, right? Yeah. Super. The general solution is, we know it is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So for finding complementary function, first we need to find the auxiliary equation. So for all the six types, the complementary function is same, right? So for same method for finding complementary function. So it is m square plus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. So we solve this for m. So it will be minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So this will be minus 2 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into 1. So this will be minus 2 plus or minus square root of 4 minus 8 by 2. So it will be minus 2 plus or minus, so it will be minus 4. So it will be 4i square divided by 2. So this will be minus 2 plus or minus 2i by 2. So if I take 2 outside, you will have minus 1 plus or minus I. So minus 1 plus or minus I is the it is the roots, right? So therefore the roots are imaginary. The roots are imaginary. So when we know when the roots are imaginary, the complementary function will be e power alpha x into a cos beta x plus b sin beta x. So here alpha is equal to minus 1, beta is we have to compare this with alpha plus or minus I beta. So we have minus 1 plus or minus I. That means beta is equal to 1, alpha is equal to minus 1. So we have e power minus x into a cos x plus b sin x. This is the complementary function. So we are coming into the very very important part, which is the particular integral, right? So particular integral will be different for type 3. So you know how to find particular integral for type 1, type 2, type 0, type 1, type 2. Now you're going to study how to find the particular integral for type 3, right? So particular integral. So the given question is 1 by, suppose you have to write 1 by d square plus 2d plus 2, d square plus 2d plus 2 of x square, right? So you have to just omit y and then you write all the term. So we have d square plus 2d plus 2. So just omit y. So you have d square plus 2d plus 2. And in the RHS you have x square. So we are going to find the particular integral for this. It's a very easy problem. So if I do one problem, then you can do every problem in your own. So what you have to do after this is, so you can see what is the least degree here. D square. We have three terms. D square, 2D, 2. So least degree is the constant term, right? So you have to take the constant term, the least degree term outside. So here the least degree term is 2, so I am going to take 2 outside. So if I take 2 outside, so here what I'm going to do is I'm going to write this as d square plus 2d plus 2 plus 1, because we don't have 2 here. So I'm just going to divide, multiply and divide by 2. So I'm going to take 2 outside. So this will be d square by 2, 2d by 2, 2 by 2, right, into x square. Now what I'm going to do is I can write this as 1 by 2 into 1 by 1 plus d square plus 2d plus 2 into x square, right? So remember, it's a very easy step. I'm just taking the constant term outside. So I'm just taking 2 outside. So in these two terms, I'm just dividing by 2. And here, if I take 2 outside, you will have only 1. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to write this as 1 by 2 into, now I'm going to put capital X to be d square plus 2d by 2. I'm going to replace all the term after this to be x. So we have 1 by 1 plus x into x square, right? Yeah. Now I can, if I take this term to up, we will have this term to be 1 plus x whole power minus 1 into x square. Remember, I'm just putting this term to be equal to x. This is the same procedure for all the sums. So don't worry, we are going to solve many problems. So this is the first problem we are solving. Okay. So this will be 1 by 2. Now use the formula 1 plus x whole power minus 1. So it is 1 minus x plus x square and so on. So you can leave at this stage. dot 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 into x square. Right? Now, this will be 1 by 2 into, now you multiply this to, you multiply x square to all the term. So, we will have x square minus x of x square plus x square of x square and so on and so on. Now, you replace x to be equal to d square plus 2d plus 2. Right? So, if you replace, now you replace capital X to be d square plus 2d plus 2 of x square plus d square plus 2d by 2 whole square x square and so on. Now, you can see the arc is x square. When you differentiate once, the arc is x square. When you differentiate once, we will have 2x. If you differentiate twice, we will have 2. If you differentiate thrice, we will have 0. So, whatever the, whenever we have d, whenever the term that are greater than d cube, that is, if you have d power 4, d power 5, d power 6, this all term will be equal to 0. So, you consider only the term up to d square. So, when you expand, so what I am going to do is, when you expand here, what will be the a plus b whole square formula? We have d power 4, okay, let me write it down. This will be 1 by 2 into x square. Now, I am going to multiply here. So, this will be 1 by 2 d square of x square, right, minus 2d by 2 of x square. Now, if I expand this in a plus b whole square formula, the terms will be d power 4 a square plus 2ab plus b square. Right? So, you can see this term will be vanished because we have to differentiate x square 4 times. This term will also be vanished. Sorry, this is d square, d cube. This term also vanished because d square into d is d cube. So, only term we have in the numerator is 4d square. So, I am going to write only 4d square. Here we have whole square. So, 4 of x square. Then all the terms will be equal to 0 because at this stage itself we have, after this stage you have, what is the formula will be d square plus 2d by 2 whole cube. So, in expand you can see every term will be d cube, d power 4, d power 5. So, all the term will be 0 after this stage. So, I'll repeat what I'm doing. So, what I'm doing is I just replace this to be x. So, I'm just using the formula 1 plus x whole inverse. Again, I'm replacing x to be equal to d square plus 2d by 2. And since r is x square, so you can have up to d square. So, I'm just multiplying this every term and expanding this. When we expand this, I'll have 3 terms. Out of these 3 terms, 2 term will be 0 because we have to differentiate x square 4 times. And then here we have to differentiate x square 3 times. So, these 2 terms will be 0. So, we have only one term here which is b square. So, b square is 4d square. And if I 2 square is 4x square, right? Yeah. Now, if I do more than 5 to 6 problems, it will be easy for you to follow. So, we will have 1 by 2 x square minus 1 by 2 t square of x square. That means you have to differentiate x square twice. So, when you differentiate once, you will have 2x. If you differentiate twice, you will have 2. Right? Yeah. So, this d will cancel. You have to differentiate x square once. So, we will have 2x. Now, 4 by 4 will get cancelled. We have to differentiate x square twice. So, 2x, 2. Right? So, we will have 2. Clear? Yeah. So, this 2 will get cancelled. So, this 2 minus 1 is 1. So, at last, we will have 1 by 2 x square minus 2x plus 1. So, 1 by 2 1 by 2 x square minus 2x plus 1 is the particular integral. Right? So, the general solution will be, the general solution is, y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. You just write the add up complementary function on the particular integral. Right? So, particular integral is 1 by 2 x square minus 2x plus 1. 1 by 2 x square minus 2x plus 1. And the complement function which we got is, I think it is c1 e power minus x into c1 cos x plus c2 sin x plus 1 by 2 x square minus 2x plus 1 is the required solution. So, So this is the first problem which we are doing in type 3. So it will be slightly difficult for you to follow. So if I do some more problems, then it will be very very easy for you, right? So when R3 is of the form, you have to take the least degree outside, and then you have to expand this with the formula 1 plus x whole inverse or 1 minus x whole inverse, and then you have to replace x to be equal to this term, and then you have to operate the RHS to this term, and you have to find the answer, right? So let me do one more problem. Let me choose red color. So the second problem is, d square minus 4d plus 4 of y equal to x square, right? X square. Okay, let me write this as x square plus 2x. So it can be any equation in polynomial, right? Yeah. So what you have to do is, you have to write, so you can also do this in single step, or you can also do this in PI1 and PI2. Okay, you can do this in any way. So what I'll do is, I will do this separately. Suppose you have to find the general solution. General solution will be y is equal to complementary function. So since you have two terms in RHS, so I'll write PI1 plus PI2. So first you will find the complementary function. So for find the complementary function, first you need to write the auxiliary equation. So for auxiliary equation, you just replace d is equal to m. So we will have m square minus 4m plus 4 is equal to 0. So we'll solve this equation. So our m will be minus of minus 4 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a. So this will be 4 plus or minus square root of 0 by 2. So this will be 4 plus 0 is 1 root. 4 minus 0 by 2 is 1 root. So the roots are 2 and 2, which are real and equal. So the roots are real and equal. The complementary function will be c1 plus c2x into e power 2x. Now what we will do is, we will find first pi1. Then we will move on to PI2. So for PA1, the RHS is x square, and for PA2, the RHS is 2x, right? Yeah. So first we will find PI1. So for PA1, the RHS is d square minus 4d plus 4 of x square. Now you have to take the least degree term outside. So 4 is the constant term here, right? So it is not mandatory that the least degree term is constant. Now suppose if you have a question like d cube minus 3d square plus 3d, in this case, you have to take 3d outside, right? So you have to take least degree outside. So if you take 4 outside, you will have 1 by 4 of. So here I'm going to divide this by 4, d square minus 4d by 4 plus. And if I take 4 outside, this will be equal to 1 of x square. So I can write this as 1 by 4, 1 by. So this is 1 plus d square. I'm just interchanging the term, d square minus 4d by 4 of x square. So this will be 1 by 4 into, so if I bring this to denominator, okay, let me replace, let capital X is equal to d square minus 4d by 4. So this will be 1 by 1 plus capital X into x square. Now if I'll bring the term to the numerator, you will have 1 plus x whole power minus 1 into x square. So we know the formula, 1 by 1 plus x square will be 1 minus x plus x square and so on into x square, right? Yeah. So we will replace x to be equal to d square minus 4d by 4. So if I replace, okay, let me multiply first, x square minus capital X of x square plus capital X square of x square and so on. Now I'll replace capital X to be equal to d square minus 4d by 4. So this will be d square minus 4d by 4 of x square plus d square minus 4d by 4 of a whole square x square. Now since we have again x square here, the first derivative will be 2x, second derivative will be 2, and third derivative will be 0, and from third derivative it will be equal to 0. So we can omit the term that are greater than d cube. So this will be 1 by 4 x square minus, I'm just multiplying d square by 4 to separately, and this will be plus 4d by 4 x square. And again, as in the previous sum here, if I expand a minus b whole square formula, it will be a square minus 2ab plus b square. So you can see this term will get vanished if I operate with x square. The only term that is left here is 16b square. So I can write that as plus 16d square. And if I take 4 outside, you have to take square here. 16d square, 16x square. I can just cancel all the terms because all the terms that are greater than this will be equal, will be vanished because we have only x square here. Suppose if you have x cube, we can have some terms next term also, right? Yeah. So this will now be changed to 1 by 4 x square minus 1 by 4. So we have differentiate x square twice. So first will be 2x, second will be 2. So we will have only 2 plus this 4 will get cancelled. So you have to differentiate x square once. So we will have 2x and this will get cancelled. So you have to differentiate x square 2 times. So it will be only 2. So this will be 1, this will be 2. So we have 1 by 4 x square plus 2x plus 2 minus 1 by 2. So this will be 1 by 4 x square plus 2x minus, plus 3 by 4. I'm just taking LCM of 2 minus 1 by 2. Right? Yeah. Sorry, this is 3 by 2, right? 3 by 2. 3 by 2. Right? Yeah, this is the PI1. Suppose if the question has only this term, only up to this, the problem is over. But we have plus 2x addition to this. So we have found PI1. Now we need to write PI2 also. What is our PI2? It is 2x, right? You can also do this at a single stroke also. You can write plus 2x also here. And you can also do this in a single stroke also. But since it's a beginning for here, since it's a beginning for type 3, I'm doing separately. At later stage, I will also do this in a single stroke. So for finding PI2, it will be 1 by d square plus 4d plus 4 of 2x. So in PA1, we have wrote x square, but here we are going to write 2x, right? So I think question is correct. D square, okay, this is for sum. D square minus 4d, okay. D square minus 4d plus 4 of 2x. In the PA1, we have x square. Now we are going to have 2x. I'm going to follow the same technique, right? So you have to take 4 outside. So if I take 4 outside, we will have d square minus 4d whole divided by 4 plus 1. So if I have minus here, we have to use 1 minus x whole inverse formula. That's it. So this will be 2x. So I can write this to be equal to 1 plus d square minus 4d divided by 4 into 2x. Now I'm going to put capital X is equal to d square minus 4d divided by 4. So when I do that, we will have 1 by 4, 1 divided by 1 plus x of 2x. So if I bring this to numerator, we will have 1 plus x the whole inverse into 2x. Now expand this. So when I expand this, we will have 1 minus x plus x square and so on into 2x. Now, it's a very important case. Here, the artist is 2x. When you differentiate once, you will have 2. When you differentiate twice, it will be 0. So we don't even consider a term that is d square term. So we can omit the term that are greater than d square. Since in the previous problem, we have x square term. So the first case will be, first data will be 2x. Second will be 2 and third will be 0. So we have considered up to d square. Now we can consider only up to d. So what we will do is, so first we will multiply x square. So x square minus x into 2x plus x square into 2x and so on. Now we will replace x is equal to d square minus 4d by 4. So when I replace x is equal to d square minus 4d by 4, so this will, you have to replace capital X, right, not small x. Will be d square minus 4d divided by 4 of 2x plus d square minus 4d divided by 4 whole square of 2x and so on. You can straight away omit this term because all the term will be, the first term will be d power 4, second term will be 4d cube, third term will be d square. So every term will be 0 here. So you can omit all the term here. You can also omit this term also, because second derivative is 0. So this term will be 1 by 4 x square minus 1 by 4 d square of 2x plus 4d by 4 of 2x. And just multiplying 2x inside with this minus. So this term will also be equal to 0, because second derivative is 0. So this 4 will get cancelled. So we have 1 by 4 x square minus 0 plus first derivative of 2x is 2. So we have 1 by 4 x square plus 2 is the pi 2. So we have found pi 1 and pi 2. So you just have to add up the general solution. You just have to add up pi 1 and pi 2. So therefore, the general solution will be, the general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral 1 plus particular integral 2. So you can just substitute here to get the required answer, right? Yeah. So now we'll move on to some more problem. Find. So now we'll move on to some higher order equations, right? So solve d square plus d of y equal to x square plus 2x plus 4. Okay, let me do this in single stroke, right? You can also do this with PA1, PA2 and PA3. So for PA3, you have to follow the type 1. So when the constant, you have to put e power 0x and then you have to follow the type 1. So let me do this in a single stroke for you, right? Yeah. So first you will find the general solution will be, the general solution will be y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. I'm going to keep this whole term to be particular integral now. Or else you can also write PA1, PA2, PA3. You can find individually also. So first I'll since you have done this problem as like this, so I'll done this in another way. So first we'll find the auxiliary equation. So auxiliary equation will be, you have to replace this term to be equal to m, and then you have to put equal to 0. So here you can see it is a second order equation, right? So if I take m outside, you will have m plus 1 is equal to 0. That means the roots are m is equal to 0, m is equal to minus 1. That means the roots are real and distinct. The roots are real and distinct. So what I am going to do is, what will the characteristic function roots are real and distinct? Is c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x. So c1 m1x is 0x plus c2 e power minus x. So that means c1 plus c2 e power minus x is the complementary function. So remember, you have to watch carefully for finding the particular integral. So it is 1 by d square plus d of x square plus 2x plus 4. Now, what is the least degree here? D square or D? So, since D is the least degree, I have to take D outside. If I take D outside, we will have D plus 1 into X square plus 2X plus 4. I again repeat, if you have watched that previous videos only, you can understand this sum, right? Yeah. So, we will have 1 by D of, 1 by D of. So, this will be 1 by 1 plus D of X square plus 2X plus 4. So this will be 1 by d. So if I take this term outside, so the numerator, you will have 1 plus d whole inverse into x square plus 2x plus 4. Remember, we have substituted this in this entire term to be equal to x. But since we have only one term here, we can easily straight away do this, right? From the previous sum, you can see we have 1 plus some two numbers, 1 plus two terms. That's why I have substituted x is equal to that term. Right, you can see we have this whole term. So since this term is large, so I have substituted x. So but here we have only one term here. So I think you can do this straight away. So you don't need to substitute the value of, put d is equal to x. So if you do that, you can also do like that also. If you do that, you have x is equal to d here. Right, x is equal to d. Now if I expand this, so we will have 1 by d of, remember you have 1 by d outside. So this will be 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on, x square plus 2x plus 4, right? Yeah. So first we'll multiply 1 to all the term. If we multiply 1 to all the term, we will have x square plus 2x plus 4 minus d of x square plus 2x plus 4 plus d square of x square plus 2x plus 4. Now we can omit this term because the largest here is x square. For x square, we will have 2 derivative. So d is 2x, d square is 2, and from d cube it will be 0. So from d cube it will be 0, this will be equal to 0, this will be equal to 0. So we can cancel, we can omit all the terms. So 1 by d of, so this will be x square plus 2x plus 4 minus, we have differentiate this entire term, so it will be 2x plus 2, this will be constant, so it will be 0. Here we differentiate twice. We differentiate twice, we will have 2x and then 2. Here we differentiate twice, so this term both will be 0. Bama, we have differentiate this term separately by 2 times. So at last we will have only, we simplify this. So we will have only 1 by d of x square plus 2x plus 4. So this will be minus 2x minus 2 plus 2. So this two term will get cancelled. So this two term will get cancelled. So we have only 1 by d of x square plus 4. 1 by d of x square plus 4. So you know what is meant by 1 by d. If it is 1 by d, you have to integrate with respect to x. If it is d of something, you have to differentiate. So if we integrate this, we will have x cube by 3 plus 4x. This is the particular integral. So the general solution will be, the general solution will be y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So just write up the particular integral here and complementary function here. Right? So I think so we have solved 3 problems in type 3. So when you can also do this in separate stroke also, PA1, PA2, PA3, and you can add up PA1 plus PA. You can do this in any way. So let me do one more problem and then I'll complete this session. Okay, let me do one last problem and then we'll complete the session and then we'll complete and then we continue in the next video. So the fourth problem will be d cube plus 8 of y equal to x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. Now again I'll do this in a single stroke, right? Yeah. So first we will find the, so you need to find the general solution. So general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So for finding complementary function, first we need to find the auxiliary equation. So auxiliary equation will be m cube plus 8 is equal to 0. Sorry, m cube plus 8 is equal to 0. So this is m cube plus 2 cube is equal to 0. So you just have to use a cube plus b cube formula. So a cube plus b cube is equal to, so a cube plus b cube will be a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. So if I compare this with m cube plus 2 cube, so we will have m plus 2 into m square minus 2m plus 4 equal to 0, right? Our a is equal to m and b is equal to 2. So, right, yeah. So, the roots will be m plus 2 is equal to 0, m square minus 2m plus 4 is equal to 0. So, when I solve this, we will have m is equal to minus of minus 2 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a. This will be 2 plus or minus square root of 4 minus 16 divided by 2. So this will be, so this will be 2 plus or minus square root of 12i square divided by 2. So if I take LCM for 12, so we'll have 2 6s are, 2 3s are, so this is 2 root 3. So 2 plus or minus I into 2 root 3 divided by 2. So if I take 2 outside, we will have 1 plus or minus I root 3. So the roots are, here the roots are m is equal to minus 2. So the roots are, minus 2 and 1 plus or minus I root 3. Remember, this is third order equation. So we will have 3 roots. So the complementary function will be, here the roots are real and distinct. So we will have c1 e power minus 2x plus here the roots are imaginary. So for this, the component function will be e power alpha x into a cos beta x plus b sin beta x. So when you compare this with alpha plus or minus I beta, we have alpha is equal to 1, beta is equal to root 3. So this will be c, okay, let me write this c, okay, e power alpha x into a, okay, let me write this as c2 cos beta x plus c3 sin beta x. So this will be c1 e power minus 2x plus e power alpha x. So alpha is 1 here. So e power x into c2 cos, our beta is root 3, root 3x plus c3 sin root 3x. This is the complementary function. So we are coming into the important part. So complementary function, you can do this very easily, right? Because we have been solving complementary function for type 0, 1, 2, 3. So we will be very good at combining the complementary function. So now we'll find the particular integral. So it is 1 by d cube plus 8. And the question is given to be d cube plus 8 of y. D cube plus 8 of y. X power 4 plus 2x plus 1. X power 4 plus 2x plus 1. So x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. So this is a type 3, right? So type 3. So what we need to do? We need to take the least coefficient outside. So here in this case is equal to 8. So we take 8 outside. We will have 1 plus d cube divided by 8 of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. So I can take 1 by 8 outside. So if I can also put this to be equal to x, right? So okay, let me do this. So 1 plus x into x square plus 2x plus 1, where capital X is equal to d cube divided by 8. So if I bring this to top or numerator, we will have 1 plus x the whole inverse of x square plus 2x plus 1 or 4x plus 1, x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. Sorry, it is x power 4. X power 4 plus 2x plus 1, x power 4 plus 2x plus 1, right? X power 4 plus 2x plus 1. Now you will use the formula 1 by 8, this is 1 minus x plus x square, sorry, plus x square minus x cube. Now remember, here the least, the highest degree is x power 4. So when you differentiate once, we will have 4x cube. Differentiate twice, we will have 12x square. Differentiate thrice, we will have 24x. If we differentiate 4, we have 24. And differentiate twice, you will have 0. So that means from d power 5 only it is equal to 0. So we will have up to x power 4. X power 4. Okay, let me write x power 5 and so on of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. In the last case, we have only x square term here. So we have stopped at d square itself, but since you have x power 4, we can go up to d power 4. So we simplify this. So I'll replace. Okay, let me multiply here. So when I multiply x power 4 plus 2x plus 1, so we will have x power 4 plus 2x plus 1 minus capital X of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1 plus capital X square of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1 minus x cube of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1 and so on, right? Yeah. So I'm going to replace capital X to be this x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. I'm going to replace capital X. Remember, our capital X is d cube by 8. So what will be our x square? So x square itself is d power 6 by 8. So we don't even term after x square, right? So since our x, suppose if x is of d, we can have some term. But since x is of d cube by 8, so if I do x square, it will be d power 6 by 64. If I put x cube, it will be d power 9 by 64 into 4, right? So you can see after this stage itself, these terms are getting vanished. So you can cancel this term, sure. So x will be, now I'm going to substitute x to be equal to d cube by 8 x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. Why I'm doing like this? Because we substitute next term also d cube by 8 whole square of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. You can see this is d power 6 term. So that means you have to operate 6 times. You have to differentiate 6 times each term. So surely at 5th time itself it is equal to 0. So at 6th time also it will be equal to 0. So you can omit all the terms that are greater than this. So you have only this term. So we will have 1 by 8 of x power 4 plus 2x plus 1 minus 1 by 8. So we have to differentiate thrice. So if I do x power 4 once, we will have 4x cube. If I do twice, we will have 12x square. If I do thrice, we will have 24x. So we will have this as 24x. Now I need to d cube thrice. So it will be 0. So it will be 0. That's it, right? So that means I'm operating d cube. I have to differentiate x power 4 3 times. If I differentiate 3 times 2x, it will be 0. Again, it will be equal to 1. So we will have 1 by 8 x power 4 plus 2x plus 1. So we will have only 3x. So minus 3x. So this will be 1 by 8 x power 4 minus x. So this will be x power 4 minus x plus 1. So 1 by 8 x power 4 minus x plus 1 is the particular integral. So you can write general solution now. The general solution is y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So just add up complementary function and the particular integral. Particular integral is 1 by x power 4 minus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Right? So we have solved 4 problems in type 3. So we'll continue solving more problems. Right? So, and I'll also give some exercise problems in the next video. We'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. Thank you. And in description, I provide the link for Telegram channel. If you haven't joined, you can also join for more updates. Right? We'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. Thank you.